In this video, we're going to solve first-order linear difference equations. Recall, a regular one-dimensional sequence is some sequence of numbers indexed by an integer k. In this case, we're going to have a sequence of vectors indexed by some integer k. And these vectors will be n-dimensional vectors. N represents the amount of the sequence you need to know in order to compute the next element of that sequence. And we encode this as the statement here, that the next element of the sequence is some matrix times the previous element of that sequence. It's important to realize when you have a first-order linear difference equation, because you can use eigenvalues and eigenvectors to compute any element of this sequence. Let's see how. With a very famous example, the Fibonacci sequence. Recall the Fibonacci sequence is defined like this. F of 0 is equal to 0, f of 1 is equal to 1, and f of k plus 1 is equal to f of k plus f of k minus 1 for k greater than or equal to 1. And see, the amount of memory we need to compute the k plus 1 term is just knowledge of the previous two terms, so I'll write this as vectors, two-dimensional vectors. Let xk equal to f of k and f of k minus 1. Then x of k plus 1 is equal to, well, that's equal to f of k plus 1, f of k, which is equal to, let's see, I'll do it here. Well, I can rewrite k plus 1 using this formula. That's equal to f of k plus f of k minus 1. And down here I still have f of k, which I can rewrite as the matrix 1, 1, 1, 0 times my f of k, f of k minus 1, which is of the form a x k. Good. So the Fibonacci sequence is in fact a first order linear difference equation. Now we're asked to find a formula for a to the k, where a is the matrix that we saw on the previous slide. We're not directly being asked to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors, but every time you see a matrix raised to a power, you should probably start thinking about using eigenvalues and eigenvectors to diagonalize the matrix, and hopefully you'll see why. First, eigenvalues.
Since the characteristic equation is det of a minus lambda I equals 0, then that's the determinant of this thing minus lambda I, so that's det 1 minus lambda 1, 1, negative lambda is equal to 0, which is lambda squared minus lambda minus 1 is equal to 0.
Might need the quadratic formula for this one.
So lambda is equal to 1 plus or minus the square root of negative 1 squared, so that's 1 minus 4ac, so that's plus 4 over 2. Ah, how lovely. This is two very special numbers. That's 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2, or 1 minus the square root of 5 over 2. This one here is known as the golden ratio, and it's usually called phi. So we'll call this phi, and this one here is negative phi to the negative 1. So let's go and find eigenvectors for lambda equals to phi, a minus phi I is equal to the matrix 1 minus phi 1 1 minus phi.
And there's a cheap trick for finding eigenvectors when you've got a 2x2 matrix and distinct eigenvalues. You can just take one of these entries, reverse it, and negate one.
So is phi 1.
And whenever you're pulling a cheap trick like this, it's probably worthwhile to just check that this is in the kernel. So you could do a quick multiplication there and verify that this is in fact in the kernel, and hence must be an eigenvector.
For lambda equals to negative phi to the minus 1, a plus phi to the minus 1 I is equal to the matrix 1 plus 1 on phi, 1, 1, 1 on phi.
And again, I'll use my cheap tricks, so is I'll take this one, reverse the entries, negate one, that is negative phi to the negative 1, 1. Excellent, my eigenvectors. And again, I'll just quickly go aside and make sure that this is in fact in the kernel here. Now let's diagonalize the matrix. So we have the eigenvalues and eigenvectors in hand. And because we have the full complement of linearly independent eigenvectors, we can diagonalize the matrix. By diagonalize the matrix, I mean write it like this, as a matrix times a diagonal matrix times a matrix inverse. So M is this matrix, D is the diagonal matrix of eigenvalues, and notice that the first eigenvalue corresponds to the first eigenvector, the second eigenvalue corresponds to the second eigenvector. Now, order is important. And I've just written up what phi was, the golden ratio, and negative the reciprocal of the golden ratio here. And writing it in this way is very special because it allows us to take powers quite easily. Recall, it's quite a laborious process to take a power of a matrix. Not so for a diagonal matrix, though. Powers of a diagonal matrix are really easy to find. So if we want a power of A, let's write it like this. Since AK, well, that's just going to be K copies of this. That's going to be MD M inverse times MD M inverse times dot 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 MD M inverse. And now I can rearrange my brackets and I'll merge this M inverse and this M into the identity matrix. I'll merge all the intermediate M and M inverses into the identity matrix as well. And all I'll get left with is M times D to the K times M inverse. Excellent. Excellent. So I've reduced taking a power of A to taking a power of D, which is really easy. I'll show you how. So M is just this matrix here, that's phi, negative phi to the negative 1, 1, 1. D to the power k, well, that's just this to the k and this to the k. So that's phi to the k, 0, 0, negative phi, brackets, negative k, like that. And an M inverse, well, I have to swap those and negate those. And divide by the determinant, so it's going to be 1 on phi plus phi inverse, and that's 1 phi, and negate those phi inverse negative 1. Good, and this here, that's just root 5, so that's nice. I'll bring that out the front. So that's 1 on square root of 5, and now I'll just merge my matrices together. This will be phi to the k plus 1, so that's that times that plus that times that. Over here I have that and that, so that's plus negative phi to the negative k plus 1. Down here I have phi to the k. And over here I have negative phi to the negative k. And I still have this matrix over here to deal with. And I'm only one matrix multiplication away from my answer.
This is equal to 1 on the square root of 5.
That's that times that. That's that plus that.
So that's 5k plus 1.
And this one here is negative phi, negative k plus 1. This term over here is phi k plus phi, negative k plus 1. And down here I have phi k minus negative phi k, negative k. And over here in the final entry I have phi k minus 1 and phi negative phi k, negative k, like that. Behold my A matrix A to the k. In part C, the purpose of this question becomes clear. We're asked to find a formula for the k plus 1th Fibonacci number. The pieces of the puzzle are in hand. We have the matrix A to the K, which is this beastly matrix right here. And recall from part A that we said X, the xkth vector is the kth and kth minus 1 elements of the Fibonacci sequence, and they had this linear relationship. This allows us to find the kth plus 1 Fibonacci number.
So since the kth plus 1 Fibonacci number, and as well as the kth for that matter, is just equal to x to the k plus 1, which by my recurrence relation is equal to a x to the k, assuming k is of course greater than 1, or equal to 1. I can reapply my recurrence relation all the way down until k is equal to 1. So that's a to the k x to the 1. So I know what a to the k is, and x to the 1, well, that's just the first and the zeroth Fibonacci numbers. So that's a to the k times the first Fibonacci number and the zeroth Fibonacci number, like that. And so the kth plus 1 entry is just this matrix times by the vector 0, 1, which gives me that entry right there. Hence f k plus 1 is equal to 1 square root 5 phi k plus 1 minus negative phi.
Behold the kth plus 1 Fibonacci number as a fixed formula of k.